the 2022 San Felipe 250. It honestly just makes me angry just thinking about it. Let's start from the beginning. The pre-run.
What's up, everybody? Thanks for clicking on this episode. My name is Andy McMillin. I am a 5-time overall winner of the Baja 1000, actually the youngest driver to ever win the overall of the Baja 1000, and one of the few drivers who win the Baja Triple Crown, which is winning every race overall, the 250, the 500, and the 1000. So this is my first episode of my relaunched YouTube channel. It's kind of been in the dark for a while, apologies for that. But I brought on some help to bring you guys some content throughout the year, covering a bunch of stuff and races as a trophy truck driver, stuff behind the scenes in the shop, and maybe some fun stuff on the side too. Today is the first day of pre-running for the San Felipe 250. So pre-running is actually when you go over the race course, get familiar with the track, mark any dangers and good lines on the GPS. San Felipe is a beautiful beach town on the Sea of Cortez down in Baja, Mexico. It's one of my favorite places on earth. The weather is amazing. The course is notoriously rough. The last time we won this race was in 2019. It was a pretty crazy race for us. We actually rolled the truck about halfway through the race, landed on our wheels, and kept going. Damn, it feels good to be a gangster. We had a battle all the way to the finish line and ended up coming home with the win. Last year in the Baja 400 in September, we had an unfortunate rollover crash and it got some considerable damage, so we spent the last 5 or 6 months rebuilding that. And while we were doing that, we figured, you know, now's a really good time to make some upgrades to the truck. So we actually have a whole new engine package from Joe Gibbs Racing, which I drove around the parking lot the other day at the race shop.
First drive, it's been a long time coming.
You know, I'm hoping it's gonna be the bee's knees and it's gonna give us that extra edge to beat the competition and be the ultimate package for our race truck.
What about the sound? Can you describe the sound?
The sound was nice. It was angry. It was obnoxious. It was loud. It was basically how you want a race truck to sound, I would think.
So today the plan for the pre-run is to do the north loop twice. The course kind of does a north loop and a southern loop, and right in the middle, it comes back toward San Felipe. Let's go get in the trucks and go rip.
Oh, beans, because mijo want beans.
All right, so we just got to race mile 45. Just had a little breakfast stop. The course so far from the start to here has been pretty fast. We hit the traditional San Felipe whoops for about 15 miles headed northbound. And then we get into some new sand washes that are pretty virgin, and it's gonna take a lot of exploring to find the fast lines through there. You know, typically there's virtual checkpoints, so we have to get within 120 feet of each virtual checkpoint. And besides that, it's pretty much open running in between virtual checkpoints. So in a lot of the new virgin stuff, there's gonna be a lot of new creative lines being made by a lot of people down here over the next couple weeks. We're just getting our eyes set on everything and see what we have to work with. With the virtual checkpoints, we call them VCPs, you basically race from VCP to VCP. And there's a marked score line, but then you can do any kind of creative lines in between. So I'll go show you guys what a VCP looks like. So this is a GPS unit, and score gives us a file to lay over. And then if I have other race courses that have used the same tracks, I'll lay those over as well. So they have little waypoints on here. You'll see VCP 22, and then you'll kind of see some lines going off. So that's just me kind of looking for stuff to see what's out there, kind of get familiar with the terrain. And there's another VCP. So we just have to get within 120 feet of each of those. But then kind of in between, it's pretty much open running. It's find a line, create a line, try to hide it as much as possible so that your competitors can't find it or can't see it. But pretty much on race day, all the virgin stuff will be straightened out for the most part. So throughout all the pre-running, guys will just come in and make straight lines from VCP to VCP. And that's why pre-running is so important.
So yeah, we're at race mile 45. We're gonna head north to Borrego. The course is gonna be a little rough for the next 5 or 6 miles. Then it kind of opens up into a nice big sand wash headed from east to west towards Borrego. And then the big Laguna Diablo dry lake bed, which is super fast. So a lot of fast stuff coming up.
What's going on here, Greg?
Oh, we're just picking up the pieces. What happened? We need a new rear fender.
Just a nice little explosion out the left rear, and we weren't really sure what happened. We kind of bottomed out on the left rear, I think, over like a little sand dune, and it just kind of caught it and ripped the left rear fender off, and we thought, oh, okay, that was something. And then we went another like 500 feet and just heard a lot of crinkling aluminum. And we thought, that's not good. At the hotel after the first day of pre-running. Pre-running went really good today, did about 277 miles. So big day, but got a lot of notes marked, got a lot of lines marked, and just getting more comfortable and familiar with the race course. Now I'm still sitting in the pre-run truck and starting to edit notes from today. So I'm just kind of going through with a fine tooth comb, making sure everything looks good. Okay, so some of this is a little top secret information, but as you can see, there's sections with not many waypoints and there's sections with a lot of waypoints. That basically means whether it's kind of open running and there's not a lot to mark, or there's lots of rocks and stuff. So you kind of see, I actually mark out the words on everything. So we'll have probably 2,000 to 2,500 waypoints for this race. And then obviously the longer, more technical races, you'll see even more. But this is what pre-running is. It's sitting inside here, getting seat time, looking at the course, marking notes, and then repeating it all the next day. So we ended up pre-running for about 9 days total. A couple new sections, one about race mile 20 to like 40. There was a lot of a virgin sand wash that we went up, which basically had no tracks on it besides the UTV that marked the course for Score International. So a lot of stuff opening up through there up until race day. Lines appearing and cutting between BCPs that, you know, the first pre-run weren't there. And then by the last pre-run, there was 18 lines going through certain sections. There's a Y in the road, you take the left, and then off that, there's a split. And then if you go left, there's three splits. If you go right off that, there's three splits. But then if you come back to the beginning and go right, there's three and four splits off each one of those you choose. So it's hard to get everything in, and you just try and find the fastest way through. Know your line for race days, so you're very comfortable when the race starts, that you at least know where you're going. That's the most important thing. Even if sometimes you don't have the most fast line through a section, knowing exactly where you're going and where you're at, that's what's most important. So the next episode will be our test sessions. First one in Placer City here east of San Diego, and the second one down in San Felipe a couple days before the race. Testing out the new Joe Gibbs engine, the new components on the race truck, and dialing in the suspension for the notoriously gnarly San Felipe whoops. Stay tuned.
Hi guys. How you doing?
Good.
We're just doing some filming out here.
Hi Daddy.
Getting ready to go on a pre-run.
Yeah.